Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers. Welcome to the Cricket Happening Show. A bit under the weather today, but always, you know, Cricket Happening Show is pretty dear to me. I'm always there to talk on this. As far as this Cricket Happening Show goes, we had a very, very good day in the first test here, in the second test match. At Mirpur, where, as I said, Pakistan were dictating terms throughout, and today they did it in a big way. As what they did is they actually set up a target. In fact, they first got Bangladesh out for 203. So Bangladesh conceded a huge 354-run lead, and they played quickly to put on 195 for 6 declared, and then put up a target in front of the Bangladeshis, where in 2 days, there are two more days to go on this match. Today was stumps on day three. Bangladesh were trailing by 487 runs. In the sense, they had 63. They had knocked off 63 of those runs, and they have been given a target which has hitherto never been achieved as far as Test cricket is concerned. No team has in the history achieved a target of more than 500 runs, even 500, I would say. In the last innings, and Bangladesh have been set such a target. They have knocked off 63 runs of that target, and they require another 487 runs with 9 wickets remaining, and they have 2 days to do so. And very surprisingly, Misbah-ul-Haq, the Pakistan captain, decided not to enforce the follow-on and decided to play on, and then set a huge target for the Bangladeshis. Now, if Bangladesh can do that, like what they did in the previous test match, where they really made a record of sorts, that is something that they'll be looking out for. They have to do something similar to that, but even that would not be probably enough. But they have 2 days to go, so one has to, and the pitch is definitely not easy to bat on, one could say. The spinners are getting something out of the wicket, the seamers are doing well, and it is not going to be easy. But Bangladesh have been set a target of 550 runs to win the match in 2 days. They need under 487 runs to actually win the match, which has never been achieved as far as Test cricket is concerned. Well, from the other match that I'll be looking at, another international fixture, unfortunately, rain proved a real spoiled sport there, as Ireland and England played in the first one-day international at the Village Malahide in Dublin, where only 18 overs were possible as far as Ireland were concerned, and Ireland were 56 for 4. They were really struggling with a lot of debutants in the English camp there. Namely, it was Mark Wood. Then Mark Wood also got his maiden wicket there. David Will also got his maiden wicket. Then they had Zafar Ansari, Jason Roy, and James Swins also making their one-day international debut. So the rain prevented any further play. So that is as far as that is concerned. And as far as the Indian Premier League 2015 was concerned, we had another exciting match that happened. It was between Chennai Super Kings and Mumbai Indians, played at the M.A. Chidambaram Stadium, Chepauk in Chennai, which is Chennai's home ground. And Chennai have never lost a match on their home ground. But today, Mumbai Indians did it to them by winning the match by 6 wickets with some heavy drama in the end, where 30 runs were required of the last 2 overs. Hardik Pandya had slammed Pawan Negi for 3 sixes, and Ambati Naidu followed it up with the fifth delivery with another 6. So 4 sixes were hit in that particular penultimate over of the innings, which made the task much simpler for the Mumbai Indians, as Mumbai Indians won the match by 6 wickets in the end with 4 balls remaining. So I'll talk about that match. But first, let's head off to the international fixture. Pakistan, as I said, were doing very well for the first 2 days. Belonged to them, no doubt about it. And today, once again, it belonged to them, as Bangladesh were all out for 203. As far as today's play was concerned, Shakib Al Hasan played a very good role. In fact, he was the one who was responsible for Bangladesh being 203 all out. His contribution was an unbeaten 89 with 14 fours and 2 sixes. And he didn't get any support. Soumya Sarkar edged on to a ball from Wahab Riaz, He was gone for three. Soumya Sarkar getting the bowling. And Wahab Riaz today was really, really bowling with lots of pace. He was hiring up the batsman. He was getting the ball to really bounce. And he was really make the ball talk there. And Wahab Riaz's hard work really paid off as he also picked up the wicket of Sugato Hume for a duck. Tajul Islam was bowled by Mohammad Hafeez for 15. But that was the time when the score was 140 for 8. As you know, Shahzad Hussain couldn't bat because he's absent hurt. And Mohammad Shahid was there at the crease. He's only 2 tests old as far as international career is concerned. And Shakib Hasan was at the other end. But one has to really, really give Mohammad Shahid all the credit because he helped, not only helped Shakib Hasan get on to 89, but he also ensured that Bangladesh will pass the 200 mark. And it was very good. In fact, if you look at it, the last wicket fell at 140. They were 140 for 8. And from there's a 63-run, 10th-wicket partnership that happened with Shakib Hasan. And look at the contribution of Mohammad Shahid. He had just got one run to his name. The balance 62 runs were scored by Shakib Ul Hasan. So that will really give you a fair inkling of how Shahid really, really defended himself. But unfortunately, Shakib Ul Hasan was doing all the good work by shielding him. But unfortunately, he couldn't do so in the end. As Yasir Shah, what he did is he got rid of Mohammad Shahid by getting him caught. He was gone for one. And finally, the Bangladesh innings came to an end. And they were all out for 203. The bowling, Junaid Khan, 2 for 26. Imran Khan, none for 31, didn't bowl today. And also, the Pakistan captain, Misbah-ul Haq, did, he did not give any bowling to his pace bowlers today, whether Junaid Khan, Imran Khan. Only Wahab Riaz was operating at one end, and he was giving the spinners Yasir Shah. So Wahab Riaz and Yasir Shah were told to operate. And they were the ones who really did it with Wahab Riaz 3 for 73, 3 for 58 for Yasir Shah. Mohammad Hafeez taking one wicket and Bangladesh conceding a huge lead of 354 runs. And one was probably thinking that Misbah-ul Haq is going, we are going to see Bangladesh bat the second time. But Misbah-ul Haq produced a surprise by not declaring the innings and instead deciding to bat. Well, so Pakistan once again batted, but they were. I'm sure they were completely on the ascendant there with 354 runs in the lead, and the target was to go for some probably quick runs, and that's what they tried, but they lost the openers pretty early. Mohammad Shahid, I thought, bowled very, very well. This is the first time one could say that Mohammad Shahid was really pitching the ball very well, getting the ball to move, and that was good to see as he first picked up the wicket of Mohammad Hafeez for naught, and he also picked up the wicket of Sami Aslam for 8. And then Azhar Ali contributed. Azhar Ali was stroking the ball well. He had just hit Soumya Sarkar for a boundary. And as you know, Bangladesh are very crippled because they don't have Shahzad Hussain to share the new ball with Mohammad Shahid, and Soumya Sarkar has to do the trundler job. And Soumya Sarkar got his maiden wicket in the form of Azhar Ali, as he was caught by Sugata Hume for 25 with 4 boundaries. Yunis Khan joined Misbah-ul Haq at that stage. And then Yunis Khan and Misbah-ul Haq. And that was then Misbah-ul Haq's innings was something which was, one knew that Misbah-ul Haq, as you know, we all know that he holds the record for the, he holds the joint record with Sir Alexander Vivian Richards of the West Indies of scoring a century of 56 balls, which he did against Australia and the United Arab Emirates. And today, once again, it was not so severe as what it was, but this was also another punishing innings for Misbah-ul Haq. Misbah-ul Haq knew what was the reason that he didn't actually make Bangladesh bat again, and he decided, and Pakistan decided to bat again. Misbah-ul Haq showed why with a beautiful, a princely innings, I would say, because he was not afraid to tonk the ball today. He was coming down the wickets to the spinners and lofting them into the stands. As far as the pace bowlers were concerned, also, he was not really, sometimes he was not even afraid to actually come down and tonk them over the cover region for fours and sixes. And that's what he precisely did. And Misbah-ul Haq, what a knock he played. 82 of 72 balls. Looked like a one-day knock there with 9 fours and 3 sixes. Yunis Khan contributing 39 with 4 boundaries before becoming a victim of Tajul Islam. Asad Shafiq made 15. Sarfraz Ahmed made a quick 5, unbeaten 18 of 14 balls with 2 fours. And once Misbah ul-Haq was into the pavilion, out for 82, Misbah ul-Haq decided that he would declare the innings closed. As Pakistan declared the innings closed, the score stood at 195 for 6, which essentially meant that Bangladesh were given a target of 550 runs to actually win this test match. And as I said, that has never happened in the annals of test history, that a team has gone to make 500 runs in the last innings of a test. So Pakistan looking clear favourites here. Mohammad Shahid, and also there's going to be a definite result because there are only two days left. Mohammad Shahid, I thought he bowled excellently. I thought this was the best spell he bowled today. 10 overs, 4 maidens, 2 for 23. Tajul Islam, 10 overs, 1 for 56. Soumya Sarkar getting his maiden test wicket. 9 overs, no maiden, 1 for 45. Shakib Al-Nidhi was none for 43. Hutham Hoon, 2 overs, none for 18. And 2.1 overs, no maiden, 1 for 8. Now, as far as Bangladesh were concerned, they were chasing 550 runs to win in the last innings. Tamim Iqbal and Imrul Case came into bat. Well, Imran Case started off in nice manner by creaming a lot of boundaries, 3 fours in all. But then what a delivery. Yasir Shah, he also did that in the first innings too. And once again, he produced a very, very good delivery, which actually went through the gate of Imran Case and hit the stumps. And Imran Case was the only wicket that Pakistan got. He was bowled by Yasir Shah for 16 with 3 fours. And at close of play, Tamim Iqbal was there on a very stroke-filled, unbeaten stroke-filled 32 with 6 boundaries, and Mominul Haq was not out on 15 with 3 boundaries. Also, Mominul Haq also played some very good strokes. In fact, he hit some very good boundaries. I thought it was of Imran Khan that he hit some very good boundaries. In fact, it was Wahab Riaz who was actually... Wahab Riaz probably, you know, Mominul Haq is pretty strong on the offside, likes to play the cut shot. He's pretty good through the point region. And I thought that Wahab Riaz in the second innings, his bowling was a bit wavered, because what he did is he kept on feeding Mominul Haq on his strong area, and Mominul Haq continued to caress him through the point region for boundaries. So at the end, Bangladesh closed the day at 63 for 1, which meant that another 487 runs they require in the next 2 days to actually win the match. So time is not a problem at all. It's a matter of application and dedication, but as I said, it's going to be pretty difficult on this particular pitch, and if at all that happens, that would be a great miracle by Bangladesh. Junaid Khan, 5 overs, no maiden, none for 19. Imran Khan, 4 overs, 1 maiden, none for 22. Yasir Shah, 3 overs, no maiden, 1 for 7, produced a beautiful delivery to Imran Case to dismiss him, and Wahab Riaz, 2 overs, none for 15, was a bit wavered in the second innings. So, all in all, tomorrow's day is going to be a very, very interesting day for sure. Well, from here, let's get on to the match between another international fixture, Ireland and England. And as I said, for England, we had 5 one-day international debutants: Zafar Ansari, Jason Roy, Vince, David Willey, and Mark Wood, the pace bowler. And Mark Wood was the man who actually gave them a quick breakthrough. In fact, Sterling was the first run out for 2, and then Porterfield, the captain, was dismissed by a sharp ball from Mark Wood, which found the stumps of Porterfield. He was gone for 7 with 1 boundary, and Niall O'Brien was dismissed by Bresnan for 10 of 8 balls with 2 fours, and Andrew Bilburney, who was trying to drive a delivery from Willey. As you know, David Willey is the son of the former cricket player Peter Willey, who is also a cricket umpire, as you know. Referee, I'm not so sure. But he also played today, he was making his debut. And he picked up the wicket of Andrew Balburney, so he got his maiden test wicket. So Mark Wood and Willey are getting their maiden one-day international wickets. And finally, when rain came, Ed Joyce was not out on 23 of 42 balls with 2 fours. Wilson was not out on 3, and the match was called off because of rain. 56 for 4 of 18 overs was Ireland's score. So the debutants had done well. Wood, 5 was 1 for 25. Bresnan, 6 overs, 2 maidens, 1 for 11. Willey, 4 overs, 1 maiden, 1 for 17. And Stephen Finn, 3 overs, 2 maidens, one run and no wicket. Now from here, I'm going to get on to the Indian Premier League 2015, and this was a match where it was something which was very interesting, because what happened was that Mumbai Indians were playing Chennai Super Kings, and and Chennai Super Kings were playing on their home ground, and Chennai Super Kings had never lost a match on their home ground, that is in Chennai. And today, as I said, that thing happened, which was very unfortunate for Chennai, as Mumbai Indians won the match. Now, Chennai Super Kings were the ones who batted first. I'm trying to get to the scores here. Please give me a moment here, dear fans and subscribers, so that I can talk to you about that. Just a moment here. So it was Mumbai Indians who actually played. Mumbai Indians and Chennai Super Kings. Chennai Super Kings were the ones who batted first. Once again, the start was good, as electrifying as ever, with the openers Dwayne Smith and Brendan McCullum getting amongst the runs. Dwayne Smith making 27. In fact, they put on 44 runs for the first wicket in 29 deliveries. Dwayne Smith making 27 of 34 balls at 4 fours. Brendan McCullum was looking into his element. He had carved the three consecutive boundaries of Vinay Kumar, but Vinay Kumar had his man, as Hitesh Pandya, who was the man of the match today, picked up all the first three catches that fell. He was 23 of 11 balls, 3 fours and 1 6, and then it was Hitesh Pandya's day, I would say, because he was the one who was responsible for taking the Mumbai Indians to victory and bagging the man of the match award. Suresh Raina contributed only 10 of as many balls with 1 4. Du Plessis making 17. And then it required Mahendra Singh Dhoni to make an unbeaten 39 of 32 balls with 2 fours and 2 sixes. But the impetus was given by Pawan Negi, who went after Marchandi Longe, whose figures were ruined by Negi as he went on to hit him for boundaries and sixes. And Negi ran out for 36 of 17 deliveries, 4 fours and 1 six. And Chennai Super Kings got a total of 158 for 5 of the 20 overs. McLenahan 4 overs, 1 for 35, but today there was no Lasith Malinga, who was playing for the Mumbai Indians, unfortunately. McLenahan 1 for 34, Longe 1 for 3rd, none for 30, Suchit 4 overs, 1 for 21, Vinay Kumar 3 overs, went for 33, 1 wicket to his name. Today Harbhajan Singh, for a change, was costly, 4 overs costing him 36 runs with 1 wicket, and then Hardik Pandya bowled 1 over for 4 runs. As far as Mumbai Indians were concerned, well, I thought Mumbai Indians had done well to actually restrict the Chennai Super Kings to only 158 for 5 of the 20 overs. And the Mumbai Indians innings went like a real train, because it was some very, very big hitting and some thoughtful hitting going on between Lendl Simmons and Parthiv Patel, the openers, who have been giving some very good starts to the Mumbai Indians in this Indian Premier League 2015. And the pace bowlers were really coming in for some severe treatment from both these batsmen. First, it was Ashish Nehra, who was really riled by Parthiv Patel, and he had a few words to say to Parthiv Patel, but Parthiv Patel, the very next ball, he dispatched it for a boundary, and Parthiv Patel and Dendal Simmons put on 84 runs for the first wicket. In 11 overs, in 10.1 overs, they had 84 runs on the board, which was pretty good going. And today Mohit Sharma suffered, Ashish Nehra in particular suffered a lot from the blade of Parthiv Patel and Simmons, as Simmons and Parthiv Patel put on 84 runs. Simmons contributing 38 of 31 balls with 3 fours and 2 sixes. Parthiv Patel contributing 45 of 32 balls with 6 fours. And then Ravichandran Ashwin was the one who dismissed both the openers in that single over, where what he did is he just gave away one run and picked up 2 wickets, which was very good to see. And finally, as Mumbai Indians were almost running away with this match, it was Ravichandran Ashwin who actually went on to put the brakes on them by dismissing both the openers. After that, there was a real struggle for the Mumbai Indians batsmen, as the bowler, in fact, it was Ravindra Jadeja who was bowling, Pawan Negi was also bowling, was also keeping a tight line. And both were doing well, and suddenly it was a real struggle for the Mumbai Indians after the openers left, with Rohit Sharma and Kiran Pollard struggling. And in the midst of all this, Wayne Bravo throughout Kiran Pollard getting run out for one, and then when Rohit Sharma was out to the bowling of Bravo for 18 off 22 balls, alarm bells were ringing in the Mumbai Indians camp with 125 for 4, with Ambati Raidu, Harbhajan Singh there. But probably one thought when Ambati Raidu was batting that one would probably see Harbhajan Singh promoted. But one saw Hardik Pandya being sent, and what a move that was to send Hardik Pandya and not Harbhajan Singh. It really paid off from 125 for 4, which was the 18th over, and that was the time when the Mumbai Indians required another 35 runs. And looking at the Chennai Super Kings, probably thought it was probably a bit tough unless Ambati Raidu could do something. But what happened was something extraordinary. In fact, it all happened when 30 runs were required in the final two overs. It was Hardik Pandya who really, really, I would say, climbed on to the bowling. And Dhoni did not give the ball to the pace bowlers in the 19th over. One does not know whether that was a blunder. He gave it to the left-arm spinner Nagy, and Hardik Pandya started off by biffing him for a six of the very first ball, and then the third and fourth balls also disappeared for sixes. And what was good was that Hardik Pandya was going at it full tilt and was striking it straight down the ground. He was targeting the long on and long off region, and three sixes were already hit. So 30 runs were required of the last two overs, and Hardik Pandya hit three sixes in four balls of Pawan Nagy to bring down the equation to just 12 balls. And to add insult to injury, it was Ambati Raidu who slammed the final delivery from Pawan Nagy for another six, and that made it 25 runs of the over. And that was pretty bad going for the Chennai Super Kings, as Pawan Nagy, whose figures were only, he had given away only 9 runs, were totally shattered, because he went for 25 of the 19th over, just the penultimate over. And then from this, after two, I mean, as I said, two overs, 30 runs required, and then it came to the final over with only 5 runs required, and it was a mere formality, as Ambati Raidu was not out on 34 of 19 deliveries, 1-4 and 3-6s. Hardik Pandya was the new hero, was the man of the match today, and he truly deserved it, because he also picked up 3 wickets, 3 good catches there, not out 21 of just 8 deliveries, but biffing 3-6s in that final over, in that penultimate over of the Mumbai Indian innings. And as far as the bowling was concerned, and that was it. Chennai Super Kings for the first time losing on their home ground here in Chennai, and losing the match by 6 wickets. Now, as far as the bowling was concerned, Ashwin bowled a superb line, 4 overs no made and 2 for 17. Mohit Sharma, 2 overs none for 19. But Ashish Nehra was the big question mark, his 3 overs costing 45 runs, and that was pretty bad going. Ravindra Jadeja, 4 overs none for 27. Pawan Nagy, 3 overs had been very good. He had given away just 9 runs, and look at the bowling figures that he had after bowling that 4th over. It cost him 25, and his figures were totally rearranged. 4 overs no made and none for 34. Dwayne Bravo, 2.2 overs no made and none for 16. And this is Hardik Pandya of Mumbai Indians was named man of the match. Well, dear fans and subscribers, that really puts an end to this cricket happening show of mine today. Hope you all enjoyed it. I'm looking forward to seeing you all tomorrow on my next cricket happening show, and also we'll have an interesting day's play coming up tomorrow on the fourth day at Mirpur, where Bangladesh have another 487 runs still to win the match. It'll be interesting to see how Bangladesh approach that particular target. Well, dear fans, subscribers, with this I'm going to end up my cricket happening show for today. Hope you all enjoyed it, and see you all tomorrow. Thank you.